Base the town and local government area in Lagos State, located in the north side of the Lekki Lagoon. It lies on the north bank of the coastal Lagos Lagoon and has road connections to Ijebu-Ode, Ikorodu and Lekki. Ekpe is situated at 6.58 degree north latitude, 3.98 degree east longitude and 42 meters elevation above the sea level. According to 2006 census, Ekpo has a population of 181,409 people. Ekpe is an ancient town with rich history dating back to the 15th century. Its foundation was anchored on two major movements. The first was by Uraka Loye, a hunter from Ileife, whose hunting expedition took him first to Ijebu-Ode and to Poka, before he finally settled down in Etiita, now in Itaopo. History also has it that Uraka Loye met Okute, Lugbasa, Alaro and Ogumode, who were all fishermen in Ekpe. The second migration took place in 1851 when King Kosoko and his entourage, comprising Eposu, Balogun Ajiniya, Chief Imam of Lagos, Muhammad Goni and Oshodi, among others, landed with 40 boats in Ekpe after obtaining approval from Awujale. Ekpe town is also surrounded by other ancient towns and communities like Ilara, Poka, Eredu and Agbowa, among others. These communities, along with Ibeju-Lekki area, are grouped together to form the Ekpe Division. In terms of classification, Ekpe and adjoining towns comprise mainly the Ijebus. Ekpes are also in good numbers, while there are other ethnic nationalities like Ilaje, Hausa, and others. By virtue of their backgrounds, the people of Ekpe cut across the three dominant faiths, that is, Islam, Christianity, and African traditional religion. There is religious tolerance, as every adherent is free to practice its religion. The religion also dictates the tradition, sociocultural practices, and beliefs of the people. Indeed, Ekpe is very rich in culture and tradition. Along with the religion, tradition, and culture are traditional festivals. Popular among these is Ebi Festival, which is common to all Ijebu-speaking people. Ebi comprises such activities like Inyofonro, Igbodo, Itaebi, Kilajolu, and Okoshi, or boat regatta, characterized by colorful display of delightfully decorated canoes and boats accompanied by exciting songs and dance steps. Another major festival is Kayo Kayo. This is linked to two movements, the ancient prophet Nua and Prince Kosoko. Its celebration coincides with the beginning of every Islamic calendar year and observes with activities like public lecture, payment of homage to ancient houses and burial sites of the founding fathers, special Jumat service, cultural display and Quranic competitions, lighting of the bamboo straw called Etufu and the grand reception at Popoaba Square. Economically, the people have by historical circumstances cohabited and developed enduring economic, political and sociocultural links with one another. Agricultural practices in form of farming and fishing are popular among the people. These are combined with processing and trading in agricultural products, popular among which is gari. As a matter of fact, the popular Oluwo fish market continue to attract people interested in fresh fish from far and wide. In terms of infrastructural development, Ekpe has not been so lucky, as the town remains largely underdeveloped. Most of the public facilities in the town, provided many years ago, are rusty and hardly functioning, while the challenges of electricity and inadequate roads have choked its development. It is in response to these, especially in fulfillment of all-inclusive governance promised by Governor Kiumi Ambodi's administration, that Ekpe, along with similar areas, are receiving infrastructural intervention in critical areas of need, one of which is construction of road. The projects, divided into three segments, comprise the upgrading of 6 km length Lagos Road, 2.31 km Ayitoro Professor Agbalajobi Road, and network of roads in Oloja Estate. The road projects will no doubt aid the economic and social development of Ekpe. As a thriving farming and fishing communities, Ekpe also has an expansive area of land for real estate development and deposit of mineral resources like bitumen. Ekpe division will also be impacted by ongoing industrial and commercial growth arising from commencement of oil refinery and petrochemical plants, including air and sea ports, among other industries within Lekki Free Zone. One major benefit of these developments is increase in population of workers coming into Ekpe, with potential growth in physical development. The need to meet the housing needs of the people will bring about increase in construction activities through building of residential and commercial structures. This is the reason for these stakeholders' meeting. Lagos State Government under Governor Akinwumi Ambode's watch is concerned about the possibility of people embarking on unapproved and illegal developments which is against the law of the state. As a result, the Ministry of Physical Planning and Urban Development and one of its agencies, Lagos State Physical Planning Permit Authority (LASPU), is advocating for all property owners and developers in Ekpe to imbibe the act of proper planning. This can be done by understanding the rules and regulations guiding various types of developments, obtaining necessary development permits, and complying with permits granted. By this, we contribute our quota to the determination of Governor Akinwumi Ambode's administration to ensure a state that is functional and where everyone comes. You're welcome.